So I guess by now, artificial intelligence is already a big part of our everyday lives, and it surely is making a big impact on several aspects of our daily routine. Imagine if tomorrow you woke up to find that facial recognition no longer unlocked your iPhone, or you couldn't ask Alexa to turn off the kitchen lights. These instances illustrate just how deeply embedded AI has become in our existence, highlighting our tremendous reliance on it, often without even realizing the extent of this dependence. These simple examples highlight some beneficial aspects of AI. Yet, when AI becomes the focal point of discussion, several critical questions emerge. People ask, will machines take over our jobs? What happens to our privacy and personal data? Is AI too intrusive, and should we be worried? Moreover, if we achieve artificial general intelligence, or AGI, are we facing a future governed by entities lacking empathy and human emotions? Such questions underscore the complex relationships we have with AI, reflecting both its advantages and the ethical dilemmas it presents. Recognizing these concerns, leaders and experts in AI are pushing for regulations. The United Nations General Assembly has called for the establishment of international guidelines to navigate the advantages and challenges of AI. This initiative highlights the essential need for standards that guarantee AI technologies are safe, secure, and reliable. Responding to this need, the European Union has introduced a set of rules known as the European AI Act, aimed at regulating the AI landscape. In this video, we'll delve into the European AI Act, examining its significance and why it deserves our attention. We'll also consider the potential for tech giants to overlook or defy this legislation. Additionally, we'll discuss whether the United States and North America should take a similar path by implementing their own AI regulatory frameworks. But before we proceed, we would like to ask you to support our channel by clicking on the subscribe button and becoming a valuable part of our community. The European AI Act represents a legal framework designed to address the risks associated with AI systems. It aims to position Europe as a global leader in this domain. The regulation sets out to offer a comprehensive set of guidelines for developers, especially in the context of particular AI applications. Moreover, the regulations seek to reduce the administrative and financial burdens on businesses, with a particular focus on supporting small and medium-sized enterprises. So basically, the primary goal of the Act is to foster the development and use of trustworthy AI across Europe and beyond. It aims to ensure that AI systems uphold fundamental human rights, including privacy and safety, while also establishing measures to manage the risks posed by highly advanced AI technologies. Some key points of the Act are: number 1, address risks associated with AI. Number 2, ban the use of AI with unacceptable risks. Number 3, make a list of high-risk AI applications and set clear and straightforward requirements for such systems. Number 4, pass AI applications through a conformity test before making them available for the general public. Finally, number 5, some sort of enforcement should be placed after the AI application is launched into the market. The regulations categorize AI systems into 3 levels based on their associated risks: minimal, limited, and high risk. Let's delve into each category. For AI applications deemed to have minimal or no risk, the EU AI Act permits their use. This category includes AI-powered video game and spam filters, with the majority of AI applications currently utilized in the EU falling into this bracket. When it comes to limited risk, this pertains to the potential transparency issues arising from AI applications. The Act mandates that users must be informed when interacting with AI-driven chatbots such as ChatGPT, Bard, and Gemini. It's crucial for users to know they are engaging with a machine to assess the credibility of the information provided. Additionally, content created by AI, including text, audio, and video, must be clearly labeled as AI-generated when published online, addressing concerns around deepfakes and ensuring transparency. Now, the high-risk category encompasses AI technologies deployed in areas critical to public well-being and safety. This category includes: number 1, AI in critical infrastructure, where its failure could endanger lives and health, such as AI-assisted robots used in medical surgeries. Number 2, AI in education, for tasks like exam scoring, which could significantly impact an individual's career trajectory. Number 3, AI applications that determine access to essential services. like credit scoring systems. This is similar to the social credit system in China, which grants or restricts access to services based on a citizen's score. High-risk AI also extends to AI's use in sensitive areas such as law enforcement, immigration, asylum, border control, the administration of justice, and the maintenance of democratic processes. These applications are carefully categorized because of their profound implications on individual freedoms and societal order. The EU AI Act defines strict pre-market obligations for high-risk AI applications because clearly, a false decision made by AI in such situations might be catastrophic. For systems categorized under the high-risk bracket, it's crucial to implement stringent protocols to mitigate potential risks. These systems must undergo thorough risk assessments to evaluate and minimize any dangers they might pose. The data utilized by such systems needs to be of the highest quality to prevent risks and avoid outcomes that could be considered discriminatory. Additionally, maintaining a detailed log of activities is essential for ensuring the traceability of results, providing a clear audit trail. To further ensure compliance and facilitate oversight, comprehensive documentation of the system, including its purpose and operational details, should be meticulously prepared. This documentation enables authorities to effectively assess the system's adherence to regulations. Moreover, it's important to provide clear and detailed information for those implementing the systems, ensuring they understand the guidelines and expectations fully. Lastly, incorporating appropriate human oversight is vital. By ensuring that there are measures in place for human intervention, the risk associated with these AI systems can be significantly reduced, safeguarding against unintended consequences and ensuring that decisions can be reviewed and, if necessary, reversed by humans. All AI applications identified as high risk are required to follow the previously mentioned procedures. This raises the question of the benefits this act offers and who stands to gain from it. Considering the widespread use of AI in sectors like healthcare, education, surveillance, and law enforcement, the AI Act plays a critical role by identifying and communicating the risks involved. This transparency aids governments in finding effective solutions and provides citizens with the knowledge to seize new opportunities safely. If you're involved with an AI-based organization or work with AI technologies, you may wonder how to implement the EU AI Act. Start by categorizing your application according to the Act's classifications. Then, follow three key steps. Conduct assessments on how your application impacts fundamental human rights, adhere to data management rules, and ensure transparency through technical documentation and user notifications. Particularly for high-risk applications, adhering to these steps is crucial to fostering a responsible AI environment. Shifting focus to whether tech giants will comply with the AI Act, it's observed that reactions have been mixed. However, the majority of companies appear to be in support of the legislation, highlighting the emphasis on security it brings. Bruna de Castro e Silva, an AI governance expert at the startup Psydot, shared with Verdict her positive outlook on the act. The EU AI Act marks a significant milestone as Europe positions itself as a leader in promoting responsible AI innovation. This achievement is the result of thorough research, extensive consultations, and dedicated work by experts and legislators. We're encouraged to see the first major regulation of AI adopt a solid, risk-based approach that is both pragmatic and impact-focused, developed through years of industry consultation. David Mirfield of Provenir and Dr. Chris Petter from Obrizum both anticipate the EU AI Act will foster a surge of investment in AI across the EU by bolstering trust in AI technology. Mirfield predicts a new investment wave, while Petter welcomes the regulation for reining in the wild west of AI, citing problematic instances like WeChat social credit scores and Clearview AI's facial recognition database as examples of the need for oversight. However, not all feedback is positive. Morgan Wright of Sentinel One highlights potential short-term drawbacks, such as service delivery delays and opportunities for adversaries not bound by EU regulations. Dr. Kjell Carlson from Domino Data Lab expresses concern, suggesting that the most daunting aspect of AI could now be the regulation itself, indicating a spectrum of industry reactions to the Act's implications and its potential impact on innovation and security within the AI sector. While everyone is entitled to their opinions, these varying perspectives raise important questions about the EU AI Act's implementation and timing. It also makes us wonder whether AI usage might face restrictions moving forward. We're eager to hear your thoughts on these matters, so please share your views in the comments below. And if you found this video informative, don't forget to hit the subscribe button.